But chances are it's not going to get played because it'll be novelty. Now, I posed the fact that people buy these things. And there has to have been the most successful novelty song. And I proposed also that that could have been Mr. Blobby. Saints preservers. Anyway, let's find out now, because we've got an expert. We've gone level three on this one. Rob Fiddaman is a music expert and historian. Rob, good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon. How are you? Thanks for giving me a call.
No, thank you for being on the programme. We you know, we do ban novelty songs, you know, for obvious reasons, because we don't want them, stuck in people's heads, frankly. And this all started with Joe Dolce and Shut Up or Your Face. And he's about as Italian as that pencil sitting on my table here. What is it about novelty songs that they have their moment in the sunshine, Rob?
I think novelty songs sort of predated that, actually. Novelty songs are a type of song sort of built up from some form of fun situation or gimmick. I mean, novelty songs achieved great popularity during the 1920s, 1930s, and of course in the 50s and 60s they had a resurgence. I mean, you had like The Laughing Policeman. I mean, that was around in about 1922. I mean, my first memory would have been of Keith Harrison Orville with Orville's Song.
I wish I could fly up to the sky, but you can't. You can't because you're a puppet. That's why you can't fly.
I know. Well, but it sold 400,000 copies, so that's quite a few gold discs. Yeah, it did. And, I mean, funny songs or songs containing humorous elements, they're not necessarily novelty songs, because you've got things like Cliff Richard when he did with the Young Ones when they re-released that one. I mean, that was a kind of a regular song, but you mean you had Star Trekking from The Firm, Barbie Girl, Ernie the Milkman from Benny Hill back in 1971, The Goodies, The Funky Gibbons, Victoria Wood, Let's Do It, The Chicken Song, Spitting Image, and don't forget Norman Wisdom, you had When I'm Cleaning Windows, The Intro Song, Crazy Frog, Barbie Girl. I mean, there's so many songs. They are earworms, although we've probably
incredibly. You've trawled up an awful lot of rather nasty memories for many people there.
Well, I do apologise.
That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. We'll purge ourselves with something good in just a moment. But I mean, some of these songs like Aqua and Barbie Girl,
they are
huge, aren't they? I mean, they are properly, not just in this country, but they become huge global hits.
They do. Well, of course, they're marketed as well for kids as well, you know, especially if there's sort of toys or they're built around the TV sort of program or something, that, you know, they will go for that song and it will become popular. Although children now, like Bob De Wilder at the time, they're quite embarrassed if it's played, you know, so some of them only have a certain shelf life. But some songs like Victoria Wood, Let's Do It, or even if you go back as far as Divorced by Billy Connolly back in 1975, I mean, some of these songs are still very popular. Bernard Cribbins, Right Said Fred.
Yes, of course,
Yeah, I mean, there is quite, when you actually sit down and look, there is quite a lot of memorable, or for want of a better word, songs that, you know, you can't really get out of your head.
Exactly. I mean, since that Victoria Wood song, I've never been able to look at a copy of a Woman's Weekly without a wry smile. Anyway, we'll move on to the most successful song. What is the most successful novelty song from the point of view of sales, I suppose?
Well, as I previously mentioned, Keith Harrison Orville's, I mean, that sold 400,000 copies. But, I mean, whether it's what's personal to you, what's nostalgic, what brings a memory back, and I think something that you always touch on, I think there's so many really to choose from. And it's very difficult and hard to pinpoint one certain song. But we do have a lot to look at.
We certainly do. So it would be fair to say that if we were to take that benchmark of the most successful song, and I'm really surprised by this, it was Keith Harris and Orville, I Wish I Could Fly.
And of course, we had Kenny Everett with the Snot Rap. I mean, you know, I think if you like a certain comedian, you know, I mean, the Monster Mash that made its way in there. They're coming to take me away. Ha ha.
Right, no. Rob, you've clearly done your research and you're really scarring me now. Rob Fiddaman, bless you for joining me this afternoon. Stay safe. Have a lovely weekend. There you go. Who would have thought? It was Keith Harrison Orville.
BBC Radio Bristol.
The only place to follow Gloucestershire and Somerset cricket.